This is Apple Employee. Hello, all YouTubers. Now, this is going to be something you probably haven't seen quite a bit before. This is going to be a video review of an old school iPod, an iPod 5th generation video. Now, I should probably do before every one of my videos, I'd like to say that my opinions and thoughts are not necessarily the thoughts and opinions of Apple Incorporated, even though I am employed by them in their retail division. Now, this here is an interesting artifact, and it's not even that old, but this is a historic iPod for the simple fact that it's the only one after the initial release of it that could play videos, and subsequent models can play videos. But, you know, if you're looking for an iPod that isn't the classic that you want to play videos, this is the way to go. And it came in two colors, white and black. I got the black one because black is so freaking cool. As you can see, this is the 30GB, which can play 7,500 songs. It's compatible with both PCs and Macs. I loved how thin it was. And even this is actually fatter than it really is. I got this guy a long time ago, but I figured I'd do this review mostly to set the template, see how I'm going to be going about doing other reviews, but also just to kind of get used to it myself, because I'm used to selling these to customers. I really love the box that the iPod came in, this kind of fold-out book style, and as you can see, the iPod is in there. Now, this iPod needed a lot of protection, and we still have a lot of people coming in to our stores just for trade-ins or repairs. And these guys, even though they're meant to play videos, are really scratched up. This one isn't because I wanted to protect it. This is the second one I got of this model because the first one had a problem with it, which I got sent into Apple Care because it's a very important thing to get your Apple Care protection plan for your iPod. And but I got it, I got them back. Probably got a new one because the phone was so scratched. And I really learned to use this guy. This is the pouch that the iPod came in. Now, with that said, let's move on to the second part of our review. Now. Now that we're at part two, let's get out the guy himself, the iPod. As you can tell, I did a little polishing job myself. You can actually polish these off with eyeglass cleaner, or you can buy iClear, which are sold at Apple stores. As you can tell, he is actually pretty different looking than your average iPod Classic, because he does have that polycarbonate cover. And this was actually kind of a blast to the past, because the only other iPods that before this that had the kind of flat face look to it were the first and second generation. Mostly because subsequent models, they kind of had a rounded off edge. But this was actually kind of a flat face, which was kind of interesting. For the iPod Classic, though, they kind of returned to the old standby of round it off. Here's the back, and you can see 30GB, which they don't do anymore. And 30GB was the first release of the iPod, so you just in there. Compared to, say, the Zoom, which its 30GB model is like that big, probably more like that big, this is actually a very well put together device. Now, user interface of the iPod is actually the same with previous iPods, except in a color format. There's the Apple guy, the Apple logo. Ooh, that's too bright. For future reference, whenever you're doing iPods and you want to do a video review, sometimes the screen is pretty glaring. So just go to brightness and kind of tone it down a little bit. So you can get that. Perfect. Now it's incredibly dim for me, but you can see it just fine. The setup is actually pretty simple for the iPod. It doesn't have cover flow like the classic. This is old school. It does have music, photos, videos, extra settings, and shuffle the songs. Those are its initial features. Of course, you know, you have the playlist, artist albums, songs, podcasts, games, composers, and audiobooks, which the feature I never use. And photos, you can get in here and set it to a slideshow, or you can just set the pictures and kind of go through them. Like that. In older iPods, people used to actually do videos like this. They'd treat it like an old Flickr movie, and they'd just go around, 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 around. Videos were a new feature for this particular iPod, and you can get your movies off of the iTunes Music Store, and you can actually get quite a bit of really cool stuff from there. We'll get to Star Trek. As long as you'll be able to see. We'll get to later on in the movie. Which is actually Star Trek First Contact. So anyway, that was a really cool feature with the video iPod. They can actually play movies. OMG, right? So, and they did that with the iPod Classic and even the iPod Touch, and now they can do it with the iPod Nanos. So what was so cool, so, you know, out of the 24th century with this iPod is actually now being done with all the iPod models, save from the shuffle. You can shuffle songs, you can see what we're now playing, which is the movie. So this is a really cool thing. Layout is pretty simple. On the top, you get the hold switch, headphone jack. It's a USB, so you plug it in from the bottom. It has a click wheel. The graphic interface is very speedy. So it's really responsive, which is nice. And that seems to be it for the iPod. You can still get it off of eBay, though, unless you want a refurb. We at the Apple Store do not sell them fresh out of the box because they've been discontinued. However, if you go on Apple.com and you look into refurbs, you can get one of these guys. Word of caution though, be sure to get protection. Get eye scans, get something that can protect the front of it, because this will scratch. And unless you're very careful like me, and you either always have it in this wonderful, very, very nice pouch that it came in, which actually is pretty nice. I mean, you can't see the screen, but it's a very nice protectorate for your iPod. And even the fact that if you just want to use it, just slip it out like that. The touch wheel is responsive through the material, and you can just look at that, click something, and put it back in. Listen to your music. Can't look at videos, but oh well. So anyway, that's my review of the iPod 30GB video model. And I will see you next time for the iPod Touch. New guy on the block. This guy is Little Brother. Thanks for watching.